Okay, in this next video, what I want to do is go over what happens when A increases, the total factor productivity, which is exogenous in the model, that makes the country grow, which means growth is exogenous in this model. And we're going to see what happens to the endogenous variables when the exogenous variables change. So growth in the Solow model is exogenous, comes from A, and we have to have A increase to have growth. And if A increases, output per worker actually increases more than that. So if A increased by, say, 1%, that would imply here that output per worker increases by more than that. And your book says something like 1.43%. So technology or whatever's an A increases 1%, and we have actually more than just 1% increase in incomes, because we get the capital deepening from more capital because of the higher incomes. Now, graphically, I want to show you, I want to look at the growth of income over time. If we put Y sub T, so our standard of living and productivity and our output per worker on that y-axis, and we use a log scale, and we put time down here, a constant rate of growth is a straight line. So if our output per worker was growing at a constant rate of like 2% a year, that would be just a straight line if it's a logarithmic scale. So this might be like 2% a year, and you know, 5% a year would be a steeper line, something like this, 5% a year. So in this model, the only way we're gonna grow, if A doesn't grow, if A doesn't increase, then over time, draw this a little better, output per worker wouldn't increase either. Now we would just have this 0% growth rate. So what this model says is we pretty much grow because A is growing. And I'll write the growth rate of A is G sub A. This will be the growth of A. according to this model, we pretty much grow because A grows, but we grow a little bit more than that. So whatever G of A is, we grow at something like 1.43 times whatever G of A is, the increase in A. So let's say G of A was, the growth of A was 2%. Then we would grow at 1.43 times 2%, which I get 2.84%. Okay, so if G of A was 2%, we would just be growing over time at like this amount right here, 2.84%, which is 1.43 times the growth of A. And if there was a change in savings, it wouldn't affect the growth rate, but it would affect the level of income. So if this point here, right here in time, we said, oh, we're going to increase the savings rate, little s. So right here, s starts increasing. We know it's going to increase the standard of living in the economy because it's going to produce, increase the capital labor ratio by capital deepening. So our output per person is going to increase. And as we get close to the steady state, say we get to the steady state right here in time, after increasing S, we would still continue growing at that same rate. We would still grow at 1.43 times G of A, we're just going to always be a little bit higher than we otherwise would have been. So the dotted line will be just 1.43 times the growth of A. The solid line here would be our level of income if our savings rate was higher. So you can see the lines have the same slope, which means we're growing at the same rate. If the lines have the same slope, it's just a solid line is above the dashed one because we have a different steady state capital labor ratio from the higher savings rate.